Dear students, welcome to the operation management class. Today we'll start about the introduction to the operation management. Myself, Dr. Raghavendra, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Bangalore. So let us see the introduction part today. So this is module one. Under this, these are some of the career syllabus for your operation management as per VTU curriculum, that is production operation introduction unit one, production operation management. Here we are going to deal with the introduction functions within the business organization, operation management function. Next, production systems, productivity, factors affecting the productivity, contemporary issues and development. Unit two deals with decision making and programming, decision making environments. And unit three is the forecasting steps on the forecasting process. Forecast based on judgment and opinion, analysis, time series data, some numericals will be there, forecasting. Next, unit four deals with the capacity and location planning, importance of capacity addition, capacity of any industrial organization or any service sector or goods sector, and developing the capacity alternatives, evaluating alternatives, need of location decision, nature of location decision, general procedure to make the location decision, evaluating facility layout, etc. So, and aggregate planning and master scheduling is one of the unit in the part B. Next, inventory management. Okay. And finally, material requirement planning, that is MRP, purchase and supply chain management. So preferably the production operation management, William and Stevenson book will be preferred for as a textbook. And one more book, B. Mahadevan. Okay. All these are the reference books you can refer for to operation management. So let us see about the objectives, that to understand the function in the organization and the classification production system, ability to understand the decision making. Whenever you start any company, whenever you work in any company, you need to take certain set of decisions. All these decisions will be learned from this subject. This is the outcome of this subject, is the objective. To understand the forecasting techniques, capacity, location plan, understand the basic aggregate planning, inventory management. Overall, to gain the knowledge in the material requirement planning, purchasing, supply chain, all these things. These are some of the objectives which are going to focusing on this subject. So let us see the definitions of operation management. Is the management of systems or a process that create goods or provide services. Operation management means it's a management in any organization or in any terms of management, maybe in the goods sector or maybe service sector. Goods sector, you may produce any component in the industries, or you may manufacture any goods or components or any tools, whatever it is. Or sometimes you are going to provide some services. Example, hotel, hospitals, all these things comes in the service sectors. So it may be any management. Okay. Managing the system, the process, overall process in the organization is called operation management. So, goods and services, every book you read, vehicle you drive, any medical treatment you receive, vehicle repair and maintenance, all this comes under goods and services. So, business organization has three functional areas. In any organization, you go it, you check with the three main departments, main areas are finance area, marketing, and operations. If you take any organization, you see all these three parts. These three parts are very important. Maybe a finance will be taken care of by some accountants, some finance people, all these things. Operations will be taken care of by the specialists. It may be production engineers, manufacturing engineers, or design engineers, whoever it is. Marketing will be took over by the sales people, sales, marketing, all these things from the marketing department. So all business are these three basic functions. These are three basic functions wherever you start, wherever you visit, wherever you read, wherever you go and see the organization, you see the three important departments. So organization, finance is responsible. As I told you, secular finance, whatever the finance or the investment you require to start the funds, to take the resources, to purchase the raw material, or to maintain the plant, or to maintain the organization, all this taken care of by finance department. Marketing is responsible for assessing the customer's wants. What some things market people, marketing people, they should know what exactly the customer is looking for. Then you can start manufacturing that or selling that point of product. Next, operation responsible for producing goods. It means manufacturing, production department, design department, all comes under this operation department. So these are three important major departments in the any organization. So in short and sweet, you can call it as a ensure finance to ensure all allocating financial resources, operation produces goods or services, marketing assess customers need and sell the promote goods or services. So we only focusing about the operations sector, not touching any financial part or any marketing kind of thing in this curriculum. The operation management only deals with this operation of any organization. So you know that any organization or any company, it will take some input and it will process and it will convert it to output. So what are the things you required for input? Input may be workers, managers, tools, equipment, materials, raw materials, land you required, energy required, information you required. You process, you operate that, and you convert it to goods or organized service. You take any example. You take a hospital as example. You require the people, doctors, materials, the land, all these things, facilities, and you the patient will be visiting the hospitals, and you treat them. Finally, you're providing the services. Okay. Similarly, you take an example of production system. You may have a bus, truck manufacturing company, or bicycle manufacturing company, or a pen, pencil, whatever the small company you take it, you should have certain inputs and you are going to convert that into a process that into raw materials into goods. So these are the basic things. So from the output, you require a feedback. Means once the output is, when the product is released to a market, then you require a feedback how the customer has received, whether the product is making good name or working, what is the response from the customer, that all the things can be taken back, feedback. Lead time, we should know about this part. Lead time, but the time between the ordering the good or receiving. Suppose you take example of a Zomato or a Swiggy, something like that. You order some Amazon or Flipkart, you order some product and you receive it. The time between this ordering and receiving is called lead time. Means suppose some customer will order for some machineries and this indigenous manufacturer will start doing working on it and finally he will going to delivery to the customer. This time from the ordering to the delivery is called lead time. Example, whatever factory, what are the inputs? You can see that steel, plastic, glass, paint, tools, etc., are there, personals. And transformation will be taking place. Maybe casting, machining, assembling, inspection, quality control, all these things will be there in the factory, the company. Finally, output will be in the terms of car. So similarly, you take hospital as an example, as a given. Doctors, nurses, medical supply equipment, laboratories, processing. You will examine the patient and you do some surgery, you do some therapy, all these things. Finally, output is with the healthy patient. Like this, you can give a number of examples, maybe education institution, something like this. So, next, we'll go to the scope of operation management. What are the scopes? Why? Operation management includes forecasting. Always, if you start any organization, you should have some forecasting. Means you should forecast what exactly the customer is looking. The capacity planning, scheduling, capacity plan, the capacity of the organization, capacity of the organization. Next, scheduling. You should schedule properly the resources. That is very important. Managing the inventories, using the raw materials, stocks, the inventory, how to utilize them, how to release. Assuring the quality is very important. If you do all the good things, finally the quality is not good, then customer will not purchase the product or buy the product. Motivating the employees is very important. Deciding where to locate the facilities. So all these three, forecasting to allocate the budget resources for upcoming period of time, checking whether next year what would be the rate of production, what is the demand, all these things, capacity planning, whether to expand the company, whether I can able to meet the customer demands in the existing facilities. All these things can be done with the capacity planning. Scheduling, the purpose of scheduling, to minimize the production time. There should not be a delay. Whenever some customers are, there should not be any delay in delivering the product to them. Okay. With the availability resources are there, we should properly plan. This is called scheduling. Managing the inventories. Successful inventory management involves create purchase plan when they are needed, but that neither too much nor too little is purchased. And keeping a track of existing inventory issues. As I told, inventory in stocks should properly maintain the stock. Otherwise, once you start production and you suddenly have some raw material, input material, other resources, is shortage in that particular resources, raw material, then it becomes a lot of problem. So this should not be there. And the whole system, whole production system will be stopped. So that should not be done. So should be the proper managing the inventory is very much important. Quality, as I told, quality is very much important. Whenever you do any product or services, if you don't provide the quality services or quality goods, then customer will never purchase. Motivating employees, effectiveness of job design rewards, employee participation training. If you motivate the employees, definitely they learn, they train, and they will get benefited. Whenever you reward some with some the when you give some rewards to the employees, they feel very happy, and they will still they participate in a better manner. They can give the better output. The productivity will get increased. Deciding the location of the company, our location, facility location, whether it depends upon the organization or a company or a product which you are choosing. If you are starting a seafood processing industry, if you start away from the sea or away from the what do you call the sea basin or what do you call sea from the distance of the sea beaches, because wherever the fishery is taking place, then you got to invest a lot of time, a lot of money there. Example, you can take it as a Bangalore as an example. There you can many people go for fishing and they will take the fish. But if you start processing industry in the Bangalore, then transportation becomes a big major problem. That should not be. Identifying the geographic location is very important. Factors affecting the facility location: the proximity to source to supply, proximity to the customer, proximity, as I told, supply, transportation, area. If you start some company and there is no population there, then it becomes a very problem. If you start some food industries, you should be near to the cities and towns. If you start a company, the laborers, the working people should come. You can able to catch them, you can able to hire them. If you start away from the cities, then it becomes a lot of problem for them. So example, here in company, you should have forecast weather, landing condition, seat in demand, next December, maybe some Christmas. So what kind of customer, where the people can, where people are moving for vacation, all this forecasting should be there. Capacity planning, how many number can I add one more extra additional flights to cities, major cities. Scheduling the plans, flight maintenance, pilots, flight attendants, managing the inventories, start flight, you should have some food, blanket, magazines, all these things. Quality of the services, safety should be maintained. Facility location, ticket, check-in counter, all these things. Yes, some example. You can give example for automobile factory. So let us see what is the production of goods. delivery of services. Production of goods results in a tangible output. You can see that the production of goods means it's a physical kind of thing where you can see, where you can feel that thing. There is a tangible output like automobile, glass, eyeglass, cricket ball, refrigerator, anything that we can see or touch is called tangible output. So delivery generally implies an act. Physician examination, physician doctor examine you, TV, auto repair, then the production of a film, a theater. We go to the hospitals, just they'll treat you. They'll take the X-ray, something like this. When you go to the theater, you can see a film on the screen. Only thing is you'll watch and come back. Thing is then they need to provide good service, means the seating, and the AC, lighting, food, drinking water, etc. All these things are services. Very good example is what Airtel, all this Jio phone, all these things are the service provider. You cannot see them, but still they're providing the services. Maybe at, okay, this thing. Consider points of comparisons: degree of customer contact, uniformity of input, labor content of jobs, uniformity of outputs, measurement of productivity, difference, amount of inventory, evaluation of work, ability, patent design. So these points are very important points in the organization. Many services involves higher degree of customer contact than manufacturing. Sometimes they require a very good contact. That is very much important in any industry. If you have very good relation with the customer, then you'll show interest in buying the product. Labor content, similarly labor content of job service offer higher degree of labor other than manufacturing jobs too. Uniformity of inputs, service operations often subjected to higher degree of variability. Client, patient, customer, repair job. Okay, somewhat a unique situation. Manufacturing operation often doesn't have a great deal of variability as inputs are controlled. Sometimes inputs will vary as it depends upon service sector or goods sector. Some sector required some kind of materials, some service sector required some kind of inputs. It will vary. It's very measurement of productivity. Productivity means the ratio of output to inputs. Its quality assurance is very important as a tool treatment and inventory, the stocks, the demand is provided. You should keep the inventory in sufficient way that there should not be any shortages, wages, the salary, perks, whatever it is, the bonus, all these things should be paid well. Ability to patent. If some product designs are often easier to patent than service design, some service cannot be patented, making them easier for competitors to copy. What happens? Some manufacturers, they start making some engines, example of automobile engine. Some other some because it has got patented. Patent means it should have been registered. It's intellectual property. So you cannot register. If you want to take that, you should pay a huge amount to the original inventor. What's the meaning of this? Typical differences between the production and services. Characteristics. Output, if you take output, in the goods sector, it's a tag. You can feel it. Never go automobile. Whenever you go to the if you take it, you do examine, they will examine, that's all. But they'll not, only the tangible service sectors are into hotel services, customer contact will be low in goods, whereas high in the service sector. Inventory is much in goods, whereas little in the service. Because in service sector, just also you take an example of a hotel, all the floors, so furnitures, everything will be same and common. Only thing is a little bit, only little change will be made. Once you vacate the room, they will change the bed, all these things. Okay. Only the food will change. Remaining all the part will be remain same. That's the meaning of that. Patentable. Usually in the goods sector, there you can see the patent things. Whereas in service sector, you cannot see. Service sector is nothing but just it's a service. So this for today. Thanks for attending. Thank you very much. Next class, we'll come up with the next another module. Thank you.